Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Still no launches since last week, but we can hopefully expect to see at least a few this coming week. The Astra 1P SES-24 mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 18th at 9:35pm UTC or 5:35pm EST. Then, some hours later, and we could see a Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 9-1 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 19th at 3am UTC or Tuesday 18th at 11pm EST. A couple of days after that, and we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission. The Starlink 10-2 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 21st at 5:47pm UTC or 1:47pm EST. SpaceX's VP of Launch posted some information about an aborted Starlink mission during the week. It says, "Tough week dealing with production challenges and then a rare scrub at engine startup yesterday on 10-2. Unfortunately, there is a real issue, so we need to go inspect the hardware in detail on this vehicle. Rocket will get set to the side and we'll pivot to SES as the rocket and payload are ready to rock. Painful, but safety and reliability are the priority. This will be the first week we've gone without a Falcon launch in a long time. Unplanned downtime due to weather or unexpected issues happens, it's how we respond that matters." There was an article posted about SpaceX being awarded more launch contracts. It says, "The US Space Force has selected Blue Origin, SpaceX and United Launch Alliance for the National Security Space Launch Phase 3 Launch Services Program. The three companies won contracts potentially worth $5.6 billion over 5 years, the Pentagon announced June 13th. Heading to Boca Chica, work is going on with the chopsticks as they prepare to catch a booster. Pieces for a huge crane that will stack the orbital Pad B tower were spotted being delivered. Base pieces for the tower were seen on trailers. They also started getting assembled at the launch site. As expected, the tower is already progressing rapidly. Ship 26 returned to the production site from Massey's." There was an animation posted of Mechazilla catching a super heavy booster. Musk responded and said, "Aiming to try this in late July." There was some good news for Starship Flight 5 from the FAA. Adrian Beale posted saying FAA will not require mishap investigation for IFT-4 of Starship. The FAA assessed the operations of the SpaceX Starship Flight 4 mission. All flight events for both Starship and Super Heavy appear to have occurred within the scope of planned and authorized activities. Here's a view of Starship 30's heatshield tiles being removed as they work to replace them all. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.